glad God's not dead.
Amen. He's alive and well. He's not in heaven wringing his hands wondering what to do. I'm thankful that he's in control. Amen. Not only is he alive and well, but he's in control. Amen. Even in a world that seems out of control, God is still in control. And that's the one to put our faith and trust in. And that's who I'm trusting in tonight. Amen. Good to be in the house of the Lord. Good to see each and every one in the Lord's house. Good to see those visiting with us tonight. And Carol and Bonnie's back with us as well. And others that are visiting with us. Good to have these ladies with us tonight as well. Thank the Lord for the day that He's given us. Amen. Service this morning. Not much to be in prayer about. We need your prayers. Just continue to remember all of our sick. And we've got several in our church going for tests and surgeries. And Linda was telling us about her surgery toward the end of the month. So let's remember her surgery. Julie Hensley has her surgery up in Philadelphia this coming week on Thursday. They're going to be traveling going up on Tuesday. So let's remember. Remember Julie, the Lord has brought her this far, and you know that the Lord is with her. It's evident that God's hands upon her, and they didn't predict that she would walk, and she's walking. After her back surgery, there was some complications after the surgery, and caused her some paralysis, but she's getting more strength back in her hands. So this surgery is to tighten up the tendons in her hands so she can grasp more. So let's just pray for her safety going up there. Pray for the doctors and the physicians as they perform the surgery, and pray for their safety coming back as well. So let's just keep her in the prayers. Anybody have a spoken up for quiz?
I have several.
Amen. Request, lift the hand. That's all. Can we come on the altar?
Thank you.
It's all of you, God. Just you alone, God. I will praise you all for the word of God. I have one way to have a great service. Thank you, God. Son Jesus, sweet, holy, rich, and every breath. Amen.
I have been Keep his promises. We need to look at us instead of looking at got those when we need it.
Need those when we need it. Sure does. Amen. Anybody else? He's not the only one in here that way. Amen.
Amen.
We've all somewhere along our way been through the fire.
Amen.
Still not a smell of smoke.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's just God.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. It's good to look back on that, ain't it?
Right.
Amen. And he's still in the fire tonight.
Amen.
Amen. If time lasts, we might be back through the fire of something, a situation in our life, but he's still the fourth man in the fire. Amen. I thank for that.
Amen.
Anybody else?
I want to thank the Lord for any blessing. I don't know if someone's last week or requested a blessing. So I'm going to pray this week. And I want to thank God for that.
Amen.
I've seen positive changes in a week's time. And of course, I've still got a lot of things to go. God's changed for that area.
Prayer changes things. Well, folks will say that it's coincidence. Things happen the way it did. I disagree with that. Amen. And God changes things. Amen. And prayer changes things. I'm thankful for praying mamas and daddies, and dear saints of God, praying church. It's I encourage people to have a church family. Amen. Don't just hop here and there. Get in somewhere and have a church family, because that family will surround you in prayer. And it's important to have that, isn't it?
Amen.
Where would we be if it had not been for somebody on their knees for us? It blesses me when someone says, there's a lady one day, I was having some tests done. This was several years ago, and my liver enzymes was high. And this was not long after I took the church, 17 years ago. But Jimmy Arnold's wife, Louvella, called, and she said, Kevin, I don't know what's going on, but I had to get up this morning early and pray for you. And I don't even have to know what's going on. I just want you to know that I'm praying for you. That's worth more than gold to me. People are praying. Amen. And that goes to show you, when God puts somebody on your heart, on your mind, stop whatever you're doing and pray for them. Amen. Because it's important. It really is. There's a reason behind it, don't you? We are. Anybody else?
Just don't break your own heat here tomorrow. I've got to do what God told me to do. I'm going to be with you. It may not be popular, but I'm going to do it anyways. Psalms 34, starting verse 17 through 19. The righteous cry, the Lord hear, and deliver them out of their trouble. The Lord is nigh to them.
trip, my sister, her friend had packed the car while we came to Paul Wilkins' funeral. And when we got, because we was going to leave early the next morning. And when we got home, I saw a box in the floor that was empty, and they had packed it, and it wasn't supposed to go. So I went out to get that box out. Evidently, we know I did. I left the hatch open all night. And we got up to leave the next morning, and the battery, the car was dead. We had to call somebody to come and jump us off. And we questioned kind of whether we really were going off. And but we, on down the road, we saw two very, very bad accidents. And had we left when we wanted to, we could have been in those accidents. But we left when God wanted us to. And we prayed about the trip, and God was so good to us, and it was such a good trip. I just thank him for that, and just taking care of us, and letting us do things like he wants us to do, right when we want to. And I've been praising him for that tonight.
Amen.
Anybody else?
Kevin, a few weeks ago, I had a request for prayer for a little baby that's pretty high, you know, across the mountain there. And serious situation, baby, just been born. And he called me on that following Friday. And he told me, he said, "That's good. All right." And we're talking about some really serious things. He said, "God is taking care of you." And I obviously, I appreciate that. But I said to him, I said, that's amazing. It's not surprising, but it's amazing. And I look back on my life and different things that God has. He has just amazed me with it. But he didn't surprise me with it. Because I know he's good. And I know he's fine with us. And I know he cares for us. But how many times, if you just think back on your life, how many times that you have just ask the Lord for something, and it happened. You weren't really surprised that it happened. Oh, he sure is amazing.
Amen.
Thank God for his power and his ability to use his power on our behalf. He cares for us tonight. Whether you, there's times I guess I just didn't care for myself, but he still cared for me.
Amen.
He is amazing.
Amen.
But he's not surprised.
Amen. His grace, his grace is amazing.
That's right.
Oh yeah. His saving grace is amazing.
Yeah.
How he saved us, amen.
Yeah.
It's amazing. His keeping grace. We've heard testimonies of his keeping grace.
Yes.
It's amazing, ain't it? His dying grace is amazing.
Amazing.
John knew what he had to write when he wrote it. Amazing grace. It's amazing.
There's a lot of blessings we don't know about that God has given us.
But what we do know about, it's enough to praise him.
Amen.
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 Can we stand and sing Amazing Grace? Without
his
grace, none of us would be here. And I'm thankful for what he's done for me, and I know he's going to do great things. Just continue to be with me in my hands and in our prayers.
Remember, these wives coming without husbands to church. Husbands coming without wives, but just pray much for them. Conviction is God's conviction prayer just as strong now as it always has been. It changes not. Amen. Let's sing Amazing Grace. Seven.
Amen.
He was talking about dishonest for the more righteous food. And I was raised in church. I saw right and wrong from the get-go. By wonderful people, I was so blessed. You know, I just say more than that. I made great mistakes, and I made my mind the decisions I made. You know, stop the church for me is to say that I made my life from such heartache and so much pain. And if they ever came, then I'm sacred and I had been raised in the church.
Amen.
And if they had people in this church prayed for me, because I know that if they had prayed for me, I wouldn't be here tonight. I just think they got that for what it means to me. When I live my heart tonight, I will deal with this, leave me alone.
Amen. So we we've kind of known about that this would happen from the time he had the radiation in his spine. But radiation has damaged a vertebrae in his back. And we knew that there would be some curvature. Wouldn't expect him the pain that he's been in. But anyway, we were concerned about, you know, is this all we're dealing with, is the vertebrae? And so he had a test done right before we went on our trip. And they called Monday, and they said, we just wanted you to know that his test come back clear. There's no cancer. And I want to thank the Lord for that. I wouldn't want to mention it. Kind of like Robin, the neighbor always said, well, people are tired of hearing you tell what the Lord's done for Corbin. But I've told you all day that, we need to tell our testimony. But I want you to keep him in your prayers. He's in the process of having another test done on his spine. They've done an x-ray and identified the vertebrae. And so they're wanting to do an MRI to do further testing of what to do and get a better look at it. He has that done, I think, July the 27th. They've scheduled him for that. So we're not really sure what direction we're going to have to go at this point, but I want to thank the Lord that He has answered the prayer, because Tiffany and I were very concerned, because neuroblastoma is known to relapse and come back in the bones. And when he started hurting, Father's Day, we went on a hike that afternoon, and he laid down. So my back's a hurt, and it scared us to death. The Lord answered that prayer. It's not cancer.
Amen.
Thank the Lord for that.
Amen.
I'd be afraid not to thank Him. And we've prayed and we ask Him. We say that a lot. You know, we need to thank Him if He answered the prayer. And thank the Lord. Just keep Him in your prayers. And they're not here, if you want me to explain, they're not here today because we've been out of town. We didn't want to be a carrier, and I've tried to keep my distance to everybody, but we definitely don't want to be a carrier to the COVID. We need to pray for all this. The numbers are going up in the county and in other surrounding counties. And just pray for those that are affected. We've heard a fellow we know that in another county lives near us, a few miles away, that has got it for the second time. And we'll be praying for all these folks. And I just continue to pray a shield of protection around our folk here, especially our elderly that has compromised immune system, and those that are still at home, you know, with sicknesses, and just pray for them. It's been good to be here tonight.
Amen.
And I'm thankful. I was really unsettled of what the Lord would have us to preach on, and that's why I guess that when the big preacher comes, there's no need to. I wouldn't touch this with a 10-foot pole. Amen. Been good to be here.
Okay, before we go, it's like I always say the same thing. I just thank the Lord that He is able to do this abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us. You know, I'm thankful that scripture never gets old. His word is always true. It's always powerful. And it never changes. And then He is our protector and our provider and our refuge and our everything in time of trouble. He is and He was and He will always be for us. And greater is He that is in us than He is in the world. And I'm just thankful for the scriptures and the promises that bring us comfort and give us hope.
Amen. I went back to the cancer doctor last week. Everything he did was about 600. I said,
That's a big thing. You leave a doctor's office and you get a good report, because you know that it could went the other way. You know, I thought of that several times, leaving the doctor's office thinking, I got a good report, but it could have went the other way.
I heard. You know, I got to thank the Lord. I listen to all these testimonies.
things that God has done. And I think about having friends in this lifetime, you know, and I know I've got a house full of friends here. I love every one of them. It's my passion. But, you know, it's so good to know, just like that song, word that I go to the Lord. Whatever it is, big or small, He can have it, no problem. And we know He will if we ask. I can never start thinking enough. I thank you for every time I come through this door. You know, we don't know the next time we'll be back. Amen. And I thank you for it. And I thank you for this service.
Amen.
Yeah.
Kim, I'd like to thank the Lord for being here tonight, for the blessing that I felt, and the service, and hearing all the wonderful testimonies and the singing. And I really needed this. Seemed like, I know we've all been through a lot of things like this year, and a lot of not knowing and worrying and, you know, about different things. But I thought about this verse, and Jeremiah says, "For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end." And I'm thankful that God holds us in the palm of His hand.
Amen.
That we're in His hands. We're in God's hands, aren't we? And as long as I'm in His hands, I'm happy. Because I know that He'll give me an expected end. And I thank the Lord for salvation. Thank the Lord for the service tonight and for blessing us.
Anybody else? It's hard to dismiss a service like this. Don't mind them afterwards, tell you to say something. There's that way. Don't go home wood. Done that before, and it ain't a good feeling either.
Feel like I've been to church tonight.
Amen.
Amen. Good to have all of our visitors with us. You've come back to be with us. You girls come back to be with us. All right. All right, that's the Danny Miller dismissing prayer.
Our Heavenly Father, again, as you do this, and pray for you again, we realize, thank you for your holy presence. Thank you, God, the realization that you bring to our lives, and that great age that you have about us. Thank you for that. Thank you for the plan of salvation. Lord, wherever we would just come with you, we're just glad to be on your side. We trust that you be with us as many parts of this coming week. Our pastor also doesn't need the Lord. Help us to be quick to speak of your goodness. Speak of our testimony. And tell them of the goodness of God and the plan of God. Help us as Christian people to take boldness in that. To be strong in that. Appreciate of every good and every perfect gift that you've sent our way. We pray for all the requests that we've heard tonight. We trust you. We love you. Thank you for all you do. We pray in Jesus' name.